All right.
That's a good start.
All right.
That's a good start. Shoutouts to 11-year-old speakers being better than like ones I got a couple of years ago. I cannot, you know, not that I'm complaining. Shoutouts to these Logitech speakers, but man, these are absolute goddamn war horses. I've had these for 12 years now, and they are still, aside from the fact that they're a bit chunky, they are a bit big. But aside from that, they are the best set of speakers I've ever had. Or I've ever seen anyone else have. They are so good. Alright then, so that's working. Now then, pause. Well, no, play this. Well, it won't take long to die if I just leave it here. Because the first thing I want to check here, really, is how the actual stream is. Because my internet here is not quite as good. My download speed's actually better than the old place, but the upload is not. And upload is more important for streaming. So we'll just see if this... I'm just letting this stream run, so... I mean, it looks fine on the feed. That looks okay. I'm not, that's not jumpy for me or laggy, so hopefully, that's the same for everybody. I'll just check YouTube real quick. Wow, YouTube is, I forget YouTube, you can actually, the pause function, like, works on YouTube, doesn't it? Let me just pause that. How far behind that?
12 years now.
Oh, I'm still talking about speakers.
Aside from the fact that they're a bit chunky, they are a bit big.
Shout out to Farnham for some flails tech on Genshin I did not know about. I'm gonna have to try that.
I've never seen anyone else have. They are so good. All right then. So that's working. Now then.
Yeah. So Twitch is fine.
Well, no. Play this. It won't take long to die by
this.
This
looks okay.
The first thing I want to check.
I don't really see. I mean, I suppose it could be different in theory, but I wouldn't know why. What's up, Treeface? Right, let's actually play for realsies then. One of the greatest things about the new setup, thanks Tree, is the king is back, baby. The king of the water bottles has returned. I now have space again for the dumbbell. I actually have a lot of space here. There is still a bit of mess to get rid of. What weapon should we play? I really feel like playing Format B. Let's play the flails. Yeah, flails. Let's play the talons rather. What's the same? Yeah, I've still got a few bits and bobs to get rid of. The amount of cardboard and plastic that I have accumulated here is kind of ridiculous, I still need to finalize this setup. For example, the wall, like right here, is completely bare. Like, this room's completely bare, so I might sound a little bit echoey compared to, you know, the previous place. I'll sort that out eventually. I just need to go back and get some, because I kept my actual sound dampening stuff from the old place, so I can go back and get that. Hopefully, if I sound like not great. I can sort that out. Ironically enough, so I have legit office setup now. It's nice. I have two setups, pretty much. I have my work PC, because I'm working from home, obviously. Which is going to be permanent. So, you know, I wanted to make sure I had, like, an actual, you know, a nice, proper work setup. But because that wall has shelves on, probably from the previous guy that lived here, they actually do a great job of, you know, dampening a lot of noise. So the mic actually sounds way better, like, in that corner. But I prefer, like, this PC being here, because it's I'll be streaming on this one. And that one's right next to a window. And that's never good. You never want, like, another light switch. Oh, what's up, Reason? I am back. Yes, it has been, I think, just over a week. since I streamed. The move went very well. Thank you for the silvers. Appreciate that. It still made me jump. What was I saying? Yeah, the move went super well. It's just been... It has been a really mental week. Here's something quite funny, actually. So, for anyone... I mean, I imagine these are quite common now on people's phones, but I got one of those, like, step counters, you know? What's up, Demian? Thank you, man. It's good to see you too. So, the week I moved was the 22nd. So, hopefully that will show up. That's just today. But all the blue ones are, like, way over, and the grey one is literally, like, 12 steps under the counter, because I just didn't have my phone on me that day. And that's literally just been, like, walking around the place, doing stuff, putting furniture together, like, you know. I haven't really been going on, like, crazy long walks. It's just been, you know, doing stuff around the place. it's accumulated that many steps. It's crazy. Oh, nice on that street. I think you're 1 month away from the next thing there, actually, though. That's cool. No worries, man. I'm glad you're liking it. I've got a lot of stuff planned, Sigma-wise, coming up. That's something that I'll talk about that tonight, actually. I might honestly just do, like, a Just Chatting stream tonight, just to kind of catch up everyone with what I'm doing. Because one of the main things about moving here, and more in general, just kind of getting my shit more together in terms of, like, videos, is, I really wanted to kind of tighten up, like, the video process and not have so many things hooked up. I was getting really, really tired of just this, like, cacophonous spaghetti junction of a setup that I've always had, like, literally for the last, I don't know, probably 15 years, because I always wanted to have, like, you know, 5 consoles set up and, like, multiple PCs, and it took me longer than it should have to realize, I guess. That's kind of why a lot of the stuff falls by the wayside. For example, the Sigma Karma run. I put up chapter 6 yesterday. Yo, look at these reds, though. I put up chapter 6 a couple of days ago. And it's been almost 2 years since I played that Karma run. And that was when... that wasn't long after Unwary sent me the splitter, the PS3, where I did the normal Karma run. I did the Sigma series for Mission Mode with Al. That was a lot of fun. And then I just got sidetracked doing something else, which I can't remember what that was. And then Sigma just completely, like, fell off the cliff in terms of videos, and yet I had a ton of stuff in mind that I wanted to do for Sigma. So I'm going to try something different being here, and that being that I'm really surprised that did not kill more than that. Keep one system set up at once and really try and focus on, you know, what I actually want to do in terms of videos, and then it will hopefully be more consistent. The biggest danger to that is I do like to game hop quite a bit. And I never, like, I don't want this to feel like a chore. So we'll see, but it's an idea. And it's nice having a, like, way you need to settle. So what's up, Junior Jones? it's good to see you too, man. It really does, yeah. This has been, like, a crazy week. If I hadn't have only just started this job, like, the job I'm at right now, I've only been there, like, 6 weeks, I probably would book, like, next week off, honestly, because I am just absolutely just done in. I'm so tired. And the bed I've got is fucking awesome here. I don't think I'll show it, because that's kind of weird, but trust me, my bed is fucking legit as hell. It's awesome. It's so goddamn hard to get out of that. But, you know, you got to. But it's nice. It's nice to have that. So. Okay, so no one said that this looks laggy yet, so that's a good sign. I suppose the added bonus is there's nobody else on the internet here except me. Oh, speaking of internet. Right, okay. Time for, like, a mini round. Holy shit, man. BT. And I'll preface this by saying, BT, you were once the bee's knees. Once upon a time, you were the go-to, okay? Like, but oh my god, how the mighty have fallen. So, I called BT, like, 3 weeks before I moved here. Right? I got my move date, like, quite early, like, in comparison to when I actually moved. So, called BT, more like, BT for any non-UK people, by the way. One of the biggest ISPs, like, in the UK. So called them up and said, oh yeah, I'm moving to this place on this day. You know, what's the, you know, want to get internet set up. Bearing in mind, by the way, that this place, that the previous owner had BT as their provider. So, literally, all they need to do is, like, turn a switch on. Like, literally, it's like, oh yeah, let's give JTB internet. It'd be that easy. Just to turn my net back on. But I digress. So I move in, and they give me, like, a date 3 days after I move to turn on my internet. I'm thinking, okay, cool, 3 days is not too bad. Like, that's fine. And it would be kind of nice to have no internet 3 days. Unplugged from the world, so to speak. Gets to the day they're supposed to turn it on, and, like, nothing happens. I think, okay, well, I'll leave it a little bit longer. And then gets to about 6 p.m. and just nothing. And and at this point, I've had, like, three texts from them saying, yeah, your internet's definitely going to come on today. Call them up. I'm like, hey, oh, but yeah, call them up, and by the way, and spend 45 goddamn minutes on hold. So call them up and then say, yeah, you know, internet's supposed to be on today, but nothing so far. Somehow the order got cancelled. They have no idea. Like, I spoke to, like, four people. I spent about 4 hours on the phone to you. No exaggeration. 4 fucking hours. Like, my entire Tuesday evening was spent just, like, doing this. And then, yeah, they just couldn't tell me, like, why the order had been cancelled. And then the initial setup date was going to be delayed, like, another 8 weeks. And I said, look, in a very polite way, but I just said, look, no offense, but, like, this is kind of a joke. I'm going to go with somebody else because, like, you guys have just taken the absolute piss setting this up. So called Virgin, and I called Virgin at, like, 9:30 Tuesday evening. 2 o'clock Thursday, like, my fiber was live. Like, shout outs to Virgin, because I just could not believe, like, how badly BT a fucking dog. I hate it when they, like, tank hits for their friends. That's super annoying. What's the thing, man? That's true. I mean, it's funny. This place, that was one of the reasons BT were going to be delayed, actually, is because this place actually isn't wired for fiber yet. And I was thinking, like, why? Like, isn't that supposed to be, like, all over the place? It's weird. Like, living here, especially now that I'm working from home as well, it got me thinking, like, are we at a point where I really feel like internet should be considered, like, a utility at this point, like your gas and electric, because I planned, obviously, to, you know, not have internet for a while. But once it got to the point where I needed to actually get online and get stuff done, like, you know, I had, like, electricity and all that to set up, I should really be paying attention. You can't do it without the internet. Like, you literally can't. You know, the era of the phone is long gone. So. Bedstream. Oh man, I don't think anybody wants to see that. I'm not pretty enough. Yeah, that's also true. And that's another thing too about your internet speed. This isn't quite as good as BT in terms of speed, but there comes a point, I think, where you know, it's like, well, yeah, the speed's nice, but, like, you guys are, apart from that, you guys are, you know, absolutely useless, so it's time to change it up a little bit. Speed, like, will only get better, so. Because I remember when Virgin first started, funnily enough, like, when other ISPs, like, got into the game, because BT had a monopoly on it for so long. When Virgin first got into it, like, they were kind of a joke, but times change, so don't be a prisoner of the moment. How is the job? It's great. It's still really cool. Yeah. They were super cool about moving. I'd only booked Tuesday off, but then, you know, when the shit hit the fan on the internet, I did actually have to, like, call my boss, like, Wednesday morning and say, yeah, you know, the internet just kind of fell off a cliff last night, and I now can't work. And he was just super cool about giving me the day off. Which is nice. The place I worked at previously was very much like a, you know, they operated on a very much like, yeah, you know, nothing ever goes wrong in life. Like, there's never ever going to be a problem as to why you can't work. It's like, no, sometimes life happens and, you know, you you need kind of a, you know, you need a break to get shit sorted. You know? But yeah, it's funny. Funny enough, I know the GAB standard, unfortunately, does not have particularly fast internet, to say the least. And it's just it's weird with how you use internet now, especially. So you've got to have hella bandwidth and like really good speed. Like that's the one thing I'm really glad of. Like there's no data caps in the UK. Like if you know for home broadband, I can't imagine living with a data cap in this day and age because. I mean, I don't know how much streaming video really takes, but I remember I watched one video on YouTube on my phone, before I had a home internet here. And that took out about a gig of my data, on my phone. I have a pretty decent amount of data. I remember looking at it later and thinking, man, that's gone down by like a gig. That must, you know, must have been that video I watched. And the video was only like 20 minutes. So a 20 minute, like 720p video on YouTube is a gig. You know, these people that watch like 5-6 hours of Netflix every day. How would you get by on a data cap?
Crazy world.
What's up, Cinematic Middleton in the comments?
It's been half a week. You're 5 and this.
Oh, man. You know one thing that's nice, though? At least ISPs, at least in the UK, at least they've stopped calling megabits megabytes now. Because that used to drive me up the fucking wall. Because they were like, yeah, you're going to get like 100 megabyte download. No, I'm not. Yeah, you are. No, I'm not. Like, that'd be, like, don't get me wrong, that'd be great. That'd be awesome, you know? Like, think of the games you could download with 100 megabyte download speed. You ain't getting it, though. Like, you mean megabit. And then they say, oh, what's the difference? And you can use the pizza analogy. Like, well, what's the difference? Okay, let's say you order a pizza in a restaurant, right, and they bring you one slice of pizza. You'd be mad. You'd be like, yo, where's the rest? You'd be like, what do you mean? It's just the same. Like, you'd be upset. How's that not? Oh, what's up, hello? It's really good, thank you. It's really great. It's coming together quite nicely. Apart from, like, just the, you know, obscene amount of cardboard I have to get rid of. Everything comes in so much cardboard in this day and age.
Get the young
people. Well, no, they don't confuse it with bytes, and this is what's annoying because, and again, this isn't really a thing anymore. But the bullshit excuse you used to get for that was like, oh, it's because of the way like internet works or whatever. And yeah, granted, like years and years ago, maybe that would have held water. But it's like, no, it's so you can put a bigger number on your advert. You know? Think about it. 1 megabyte, right? What's 8 is a bigger number than 1. So even if you only have like 3 megabyte download, that's 24 like megabit. So you can say, oh, it's 24. And now, to be fair, like you can actually get like 100 megabit download. Like I have that here. I had it at the old place. So now you can actually have it. Oh my god, that would have been really great if I'd have actually remembered to equip the right number. But I didn't. Yeah, but that's the excuse they used to give. Was like, oh, it's because of that. And it's like, no, it isn't. Like, come on. It's so you can put a way bigger number on your advert. Like, shut up. But so many people just don't know, so they had no reason to. But it got to the point where I think it was the Gadget Show, actually, if anybody remembers. And this is a while ago. But the Gadget Show used to be this like tech show that was on Channel 5 in the UK. They did like a whole episode on it of like, yeah, like, you know, ISPs like need to stop doing this because like it is quite literally false advertising because they're saying megabyte. It's like, no, it's like you are nowhere near getting that kind of download. Be great if it was. I saw a Linus Tech Tips video recently where he had some crazy setup. Fun fact, actually, it was to do with his CPU, I think, which is how he could download so fast. I think he was downloading at like 70 megabytes a second or something like that. So damn, that's pretty nice. Like, we'd all like that kind of download. If he hasn't given me a blue, I was going to say I'm probably dead. Find the ninja, Ryu. I just thought, right, okay, hang on a minute. I mean, it's not a good idea, because, say, survival, you want consistency. Could you do, like, I'm thinking, could you do forward Y, and then do forward Y, Y? Because that spin kick does so much damage. But it's, again, it's like, get hit, then. Oh, shit.
Oh, what's up, Mike? I agree. Yeah, numbers can lie very well. Yeah, it's true. I mean, imagine if you bought a hard drive that said, like, you know, 100 gigabytes on it. Well, no, like, who'd buy a 100 gigabyte hard drive now, but you know what I mean. And it was actually gigabit. You'd be annoyed.
You'd be pissed. All right. Okay, so this is all working okay. Whoops, that was my controller.
Falling on the floor.
See daisy? Alright then. Yeah, because I'll probably be... I don't know if I'm going to stream tonight, honestly. I might just have tonight off. Today's been pretty busy as well. But I'll stream properly tomorrow. Let's play with Tom for... and we'll have a proper catch-up. Because I just want to make sure this all works. Because when I first set up my PC, I had no audio for some reason. I have my console audio and that piped into the same thing. And I just had no audio for some reason. And I thought, why does this happen? Like, why when you move somewhere, or like when you unplug something, and then you plug it all back in the exact same way, sometimes shit just doesn't work. It's just, it's no fun. It's 8 times less or 8 times more. Exactly, yeah. Exactly, it's... Again, the pizza analogy. Like, generally speaking, like, I think it's pretty fair to say, like, you know, pizzas come in 8 slices more often than not. Like, you know, a decent sized pizza, you can get 8 slices out of a decent sized pizza. So if you've got a pizza and you only got 1 slice instead of 8, you'd be pissed. Or a pie, or like a really big cake. But yeah, it was really, like, when the guy came here, he was like, yeah, 100 megabit. And I was like, you didn't say megabytes. Good man. Some BT engineers still do, by the way. Just a fun fact. I've had more than one BT engineer be like, yeah, you're going to get, like, 500 megabyte download. But... it's like, can I quote you on that? I definitely said bytes, not bit.
What's up, Zunadok? I saw you mentioning you wanted to do a no-UT run. How'd you kill the worm boss with no-UTs?
You can do the worm boss. I mean, honestly, like, the best of ways to kill him is without UTs. You can use the Y-string with the scythe on him. That works really, really well. The Y-string with the, sorry, golem also works really, really well for the worm. There's a couple of things. Like, UTs is probably the safest, but there are actually, like, better ways to kill the worm. You can stun lock him too, actually. I didn't even know about stun lock when I did that no UT run. That no UT run is old. The Garja Brawl video, I think on my old YouTube channel, is from that run. And I don't know how old that, like, that's an old video. So I don't think that stun lock thing was very bad. I've had a couple of ideas regarding no UT runs for Black and Sigma too. Playing Sigma, so I'm forgetting that it's the left analog stick. Like, so. You have to hit him with normals as it's coming. Yeah. Oh shit. Yes, you do. Yeah. So you pretty much the same like setup. You would get in one of the doorways and kind of listen for him coming, and then you can just hit him with normal strings like as he moves past. And sometimes you'll stun him like more than once, and you can actually get a decent amount of damage. That's one good thing about that boss. Like, he's annoying, but he doesn't have a ton of health, so, like, you can take him out pretty quickly. Especially if you use the Psy. Sorry, God. I gotta be honest, I really just want to try that. Hang on a minute. I gotta try something. Farnham sent me some tech about the flails on Genshin that I really want to try. I think... No! Where's my actual save slot? There we are. Is that before Genshin? I think it is. Yeah, I think that's before Genshin. Oh, what's up, Gabe? Yes, new surroundings.
Nothing is decorated yet, though.
Well, nothing in the offices. Although I did... I was going to say splurge, but it was only 30 quid. I did get myself a second mechanical keyboard for my work PC. Because they gave me a keyboard. And I thought, okay, cool. Like, that saves me having to get one. Typed literally three words on it, and I just... I can't go back, man. I'm officially a keyboard snob. I can't go back to a membrane keyboard. Just typing on them just... That must be like the waiting room. Like, if you die and you go to hell, that's probably the waiting room. Like, you're just sat there typing on a membrane keyboard while you wait to see, like, you know, what room you've got. Because it's just such a... It's such a sad experience. I love the clickiness. It's good shit. Yeah, okay, so let me just practice this before I go. So it was, So, 1-2. Ah, I see, okay. So I think that was it, wasn't it? Yeah, it was. Let me just check here. It's forward Y. And you can do it four times. Okay, so it's kind of like the scythe. Hmm. That's pretty easy to cancel, so. Alright, let's try that. I'm still looking for something on the Tonfa for Genshin. For survival. Because that Heavenly Justice Rotate Y is hella good, but... Ooh, okay, that's... Is that actually more damage, though? That is pretty chunky. But what if I do... Stop being a wise guy. That, yeah, that is actually way, that's way more damage. So could you do... Alright, so let's try and get cheeky. Could you do... Yeah, you see, I don't like that he can do that. You could probably... I bet you could probably do... I mean, again, I wouldn't try it in survival, but I bet you could probably do, like, three of them. And then actually end... How did that hit... Yeah, I bet you could do three of them and actually just do forward Y. Like, so then you'd get, like, forward Y, you get three cancels, and then you'd actually get forward Y after it. It's weird how, like, one hit does more damage than two hits, though. Mm-mm. I won't do that. There we are. Yeah, because the one thing with the Tonfa on that Rotate Y, if he ground pounds, like, you're dead. Which is really annoying. You can do YY Heavenly Justice Y. It just doesn't do anywhere near the amount of damage. And it's one of the best things about the Tonfa, is that you can just absolutely delete his health bar. If only you had... If only every weapon was as good at Genshin as the Scythe. If only. It's such a good weapon. There we go. Man, everything looks so good on this monitor. Just, oh my god. Probably not really making a difference to the stream, but... Okay, that's actually not too bad. Okay, so you've got to like cancel. You've got to like confirm the cancel because you can stun him, but he can still like kind of break out of that. Yeah, so that's two forward wise. Yeah, see, that's what you gotta watch out for. me, as it seemed to have not as much health. Yeah, so you've got to basically confirm that first hit, and then kind of keep an eye on what he's doing. That is a lot of damage. Yeah, that is a lot of damage. I'd say that is definitely worth practicing. If you can reduce the amount of times you actually have to hit Genshin in survival, that's a big deal. So he even mentions that. So you could do forward Y. You could hit confirm forward Y. And then just do forward Y shuriken. Yeah. Why has that got GB in front of it? Is that Twitch? I didn't put that there. My title is really weird. Oh, what's up, Chris? It's great, Tom. It is really great. I might do a tour when everything's like set up and everything. Everything's like good to go. I didn't do it at my last place because I had a roommate there. I mean, to be fair, she probably wouldn't have minded, but this is just me here, so there's no one to get, you know, there's no one to be like, hey, don't do that. It's so weird. I actually went out today in my local town, like main city, for the first time in a good few months. Holy crap, man, it was eerie. Like, if you want to make, like, a post-apocalyptic movie, like, in, like, now is the time to get, like, your B-roll. Yeah, so that's what I want, so. God, that is chonky damage, though. Alright, calm down, mate. He doesn't do that in survival, does he? I just did not get my dash there. Come on. That's nice damage. That is nice damage. Okay, so... yeah, you can probably survive this. So the safest sequence is that. Yeah, let me restart. Yeah. So the safest sequence is going to be forward Y two hits, forward Y shuriken cancel, forward Y shuriken cancel, and you can attempt another one. But like the scythe, sometimes you can get five hits with the scythe. He doesn't always let you do it, but sometimes he does. So, what's up, Albo? What's up, you? I mean, I'm not playing survival anymore. What are we on here? I'm probably going to wrap up in a minute, actually. I'm going to check on my dinner. Check on my lunch. Cooking bolognese. It's nice. I'm actually trying vegetarian bolognese because I've got some of that corn mince. I don't really know what that is, which is why it's kind of always put me off trying it. But I figured, we'll give it a go. It's a lot cheaper. It's a lot cheaper than meat. Man, it's been a year and 2 months now since I kind of stopped eating meat. I've had it like here and there, like since, just when it's kind of ow. Like for example, Christmas dinner. I wasn't going to be like, no, no, you have to cook something specifically with me. But I noticed, man, it's, don't feel great after having eaten meat after so long. Maybe it's just because your body needs to get used to it again, but... So that's two hits. That's two forward Ys. Yes!
What's up, VHS? Thanks for the sub. Man, 17 months. What a beast. Joe got his bachelor back. I mean, I do have a king-size bed, so kind of, yeah. And it's fucking nice. Like, honestly, the bed's so nice. It's like, I kind of treated myself with the bed, I'm not going to lie. He usually blocks or dodges after four hits. Yeah, he does, Chris. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. You usually get four hits. So, but sometimes, like, he'll let you get a cheeky fifth hit. Stop teleporting. Okay, so I need to tidy that up. Because I'm sure it can cancel. Ooh. Yeah. I'm sure I can cancelling like out of habit on that first hit. I need to not do that. God, that is a lot. That is about twice the damage. So. I don't know if that's me just being late on my block, or... I wouldn't say it's worth doing it on the first one. Like, that's... Because I can block that if I do forward Y. If I do forward Y cancel, I can't block that. And your health bar's nowhere near this big in survival, so... Too low on health. awesome, Jimmy. I'm doing well, great. I'm doing well, thank you. I hope you are too. I'm doing great, actually. It's nice. Reminds me of a story Potts told me. In the service, ate rice and veggies for over a year, had a big feast when he returned, and everybody got ill from the diet change. Yeah, it doesn't surprise me. I've never tried corn mince, though. Usually a lot of the meat substitute stuff, like... I don't know. You know what, Demon? That's probably a good point. Yeah, it probably is quicker to just get killed. Yeah. So, man, I have not had a kebab. God. I have not had a kebab in a long, long time. How's the damage with 360Y flails? I've never tried it, to be honest, Chris. Like, generally speaking, against Genshin, like, any move that kind of commits you to an animation, like, you want to avoid because, you can hit him once, but then he can just kind of break out of that and hit you. So if you're, like, committed to an animation, then, like, you'll get tagged by whatever he does. It's annoyingly enough, it's what makes the scythe just, like, the god weapon for it. Because just, like, a single Y move, like, just is so safe. So, what do I prefer visually, NG2 or NGS2? I haven't played NGS2 in so long. I'd have to play it again, really, to remind myself what it looks like. Yeah, he doesn't seem to, like, let you get that. Yeah, like, he hasn't let me get that. Yeah. He hasn't let me get, like, forward Y cancel, forward Y. He's always, like, got out of the last hit. Why does one hit do more damage than two, though? That doesn't really make any sense. Like, that's really weird. God, man, like, that does, like, no damage. That's such a powerful move. Yeah, it doesn't seem like he's gonna let me get that. I mean, it's Judgment Call. It is a lot more damage. Like, it's a lot more damage. It really is. But I don't know if it's worth the risk. Especially in, like, later rounds. So, did you team missions on NGS2? No, I didn't. I really didn't play NGS2 much, to be honest. I played it up until Master Ninja. Like, I beat Master Ninja, and then that was it. Go away.
I didn't really play it much after that because I felt like it kind of just changed. It changed a lot of what I liked about NG2. NGS2 kind of changed that stuff, which I just wasn't a fan of. What weapon should we play? Actually, it's not a great idea to play a survivor because I could be here for like an hour and a half. You know what? We'll play the Kusarigama, but we'll just play like brute force for score. We'll see how this goes. This could go either really well or really badly. What's up, Ifiora? I don't know if that's how I said that. Corn and tofu, okay. I don't have any real taste of their own. It's all about adding. Oh yeah, I did. Yeah, I basically made like a bolognese without meat. So. Avoid it all cost. Yeah, I never really tried them, because I'm not really sure what they are. I still have Sigma 2, yeah. The only problem is, I don't have any data for Sigma 2, because the PS3 I had Sigma 2 on, originally, well, the PS3 I played it on, that died a long time ago, so. That was a rough data loss. Oh, what's up, Laser? That was a rough data loss, that was, my fat PS3. That made me sad. All my original Sigma data was on that, which to this day still kind of stings when I think about it. Like, all my mission mode scores, all my survival shit for Sigma was on that PS3. And it's just gone. Like, it's just completely gone. And funny enough, I played a... I actually have a Sigma survival video coming up. Because one of the video ideas I had was to redo all of survival in Sigma, new videos for it, but I don't think I'm gonna do that. Because it's so fucking boring. After playing NG2 survival, like, Sigma 1 survival is just... it does not cut the mustard. It doesn't even graze the mustard. Like, it's just so... It just feels so tame. Ooh. I don't think so. At least I got my multiplier. I've not really been up to much, to be honest, Laser. I moved this week, so I've literally just been basically unpacking, doing boring shit, like getting council tax and bills and shit, so. Sorting out internet. Yeah, just boring, adult stuff. All that boring crap that nobody really likes doing. But you gotta do it. I mean, like, that. Just that is so good. And also, one thing I forgot, actually, playing Sigma Survival again. The amount of, like, one-hitter guy waves is... There's a lot. Like, I think I did the Villaro, and I think there's about six waves that have, like, wasps or pill bugs in them, which are just, like, quite literally, like, you just hit them once, and that's it. It's just kind of boring. I would say tofu is a better alternative to meat, but you have those soy fungus-type substitutes. Yeah, I probably need to try a few, to be honest. Because it's unquestionable, like, when I do... And I think I've only eaten meat that I can remember, like, probably twice in the last year. And you feel it afterwards. It's like, I don't know. It's hard to explain. So, did I say Piola? No. I don't know what you... I don't know what that's referring to. I missed that one. So, I heard the online wasn't particularly great. Oh, what's up, Disorder? Thank you for the bits. I'm streaming NG2 right now. Nice. Go watch him, people. Because I'm going to be stopping in a minute, so let's play Hitman 3. Man, I do need to play Hitman. Yeah, Hitman is... God, I haven't even... I have Hitman 1. Not Hitman 1. I have, Hitman. The new one. The first one. I have that on PS4. I just haven't played it. It's in the backlog, man. No, I got a flat. I'm renting. I didn't buy a place. That's what I was originally looking at, was buying a place, but it's right now, like, viewings and that are kind of a pain, and it's not really, the world's in a weird place right now, so I figure, I'll wait, and I'm fortunate enough to where, like, I've been very, very strict, like, the last decade or so. Like, I'm okay with regards to, like, looking for a house and that. So, I figured I'd just, you know, get a place for now that's, like, just for me. Like, just my place. Like, this is, you know, JTB headquarters, you might say. And then we'll just take it from there. We'll see what happens.
Oh, thanks for sub, Sorn. NGS2 is online and has... Oh, does, yeah, say... And correct me if I'm wrong. There's no way... there's no way to play it, like, locally, is there? You can't just, like, system link two PS3s together and essentially play, like, a local connection. Because I know that was one thing I was thinking of trying. Just to, like, see if it worked. But I think someone else actually tried it before. But it was like, no, like, you actually can't do that. Like, it has to be online. Which is really weird. Yeah, I never actually tried NG2's... NGS2, sorry. Online. I've not really been playing for score here. I've just been kind of pissed about. Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, the online on the PS3 was not the best. That is true. That's a very good point. You know, though, shout-outs to the PS3. I've been using my PS3 a lot lately, just through playing Sigma. The PS3 literally has a better UI than the PS4, which is, like, such a blow-up. Like, the PS3's UI is, like, way more responsive than the PS4's. It's super weird. By the way, speaking of PlayStations, I put my PS5 away to move. I actually haven't unpacked it yet. Because there's just nothing on it I want to play. I feel like the PS5, I genuinely think I just kept my pre-order because I got one. I was like, oh, I got a pre-order, that's kind of cool. I didn't really think it through. I have strongly been considering selling my PS5 just because, like, of how much they're going for right now still on eBay. Like, they're still going for, like, 800. I'm thinking, man, that's... Like, that'd be nice. That'd be a nice little profit. Because there's literally nothing on it, like, that I want to play. Like, the only thing I have on it is Black Ops. And I could just play that on PS4. I don't think I'll be playing Black Ops that much in the foreseeable future, because I got NG videos. That's death. I just scout your PS1. I'll be for a tether. Oh, what's up, Demon? Oh yeah, the tier 3. So the hair is getting long, as you can probably see. It's not even in camera anymore. I don't know what to do with this hair. It's been a long time since I've had really long hair, so. PS3 online was not the best, but it is free. That's true. Man, speaking of online, how about that Xbox Live price increase that people were not a fan of? People were like, yo, no, you can't do that. That's not cool. You know, it's weird, but it's been a while since I've streamed. And, you know, been a while since I've seen the overlay. This overlay looks so good. It really does. Joe becoming a scalper, didn't Microsoft buckle? Yeah, they did. They did. Yep. And that reminds me, I think I'm gonna... That's another thing, too. I'm probably gonna cancel Game Pass. Game Pass has got to a point where... Now it's just becoming a backlog. And the scope of it is, like, actively putting me off actually playing anything. Because I think, man, I've got, like, 50 games in that I want to play. I'm going to turn off my Game Pass subscription. Because I bought a year, so I don't know when it'll run out. But I'm going to turn it off and see, like, hopefully I'm thinking that. I think, okay, yeah, I'll look at these games and think, right, I really want to play 3. And I'll just buy them. It's sort of the Netflix syndrome of, like, people will, like, watch everything, but because it's just there, but they don't really take in it all in backlog pass. Yeah. And how much is, I'm trying to think, how much is, like, just Xbox Live now? I think in the UK a year is, like, is it 40 or 50 quid? Because I think that's one thing, whereas in the US it's quite a bit more expensive than it is here. Let's have a look on Amazon. Xbox Live Gold. Yeah, a 12-month membership is 50 quid. And how much is it in the US?
Is it $70 or $75? It's quite a bit more than it is here. What's the spookiest place I've ever been to? That's a good question. I'm not sure. Oh, is it 60? Oh, okay, it's 60. Yeah, so I mean, that's not a lot. I don't know. I still feel like Xbox Live and PSN, for what you get, especially PSN, because I'm sorry, but the Xbox games with gold, let's be real, most of them are kind of whack. But the games they give you on PlayStation Plus, like, a good chunk of my PS4 library is PlayStation Plus games. And it's like 50 quid a year. Like, that's pretty goddamn good for what you get. And of course, you know, there's always going to be the ones that are like, yeah, but it was free. And to that, it's like, yeah, well, it's not anymore. Deal with it. Like, if you don't want it, don't buy it. If you don't want it, don't pay for it. No one is forcing you to pay for it. So let's have a look at PlayStation Plus. And a 12-month... Yeah, so 12 months of PlayStation Plus is the same. It's 50 quid. But that doesn't get you PlayStation Now, does it? I can't remember what the... I think Xbox Live Ultimate, isn't that the one that has Game Pass in it? Or is it Game Pass Ultimate has Gold Live in it? Xbox... Game Pass Ultimate 12 months. Okay, there isn't a 12-month option showing up on Amazon. That's weird. Well, a 3-month subscription for Game Pass Ultimate's 30 quid. So if you wanted a year, that would be 120 quid. I mean, if the Xbox is your only system... I think this kind of gets into a different thing, though. When you've got multiple systems, I think it's less enticing to have those subscriptions. If you only have an Xbox, then yeah, that's great. But if you have an Xbox, a PlayStation, a PC, you know, you think, well, your time is split between three platforms, so... Yeah, month to month. I mean, month to month is garbage, though. Month to month for anything is pretty much a rip-off. CD Keys has a year of Game Pass Ultimate for 99 quid. I mean, that's really good. Again, if you play a lot of shit, which I don't, so that's kind of why I'm thinking of getting rid of it, because I haven't played a Game Pass game. Ori and the Blind Forest was the last Game Pass game I played, and that was what I want to say. That was like March last year. So I've basically been paying for Game Pass for like 9 months, and I haven't used it. So, that's crazy. My friend and I share, I pay for Game Pass, and he plays for PlayStation Plus. That would be really cool. Yeah, that's really cool if you got someone that you can do that with. I think the main value of the GPU will be late 2021. Speaking of which, again, it was a Linus Tech Tips video, actually. They tried to do a, like, Xbox Series X, like, PC to beat it, and they ended up with a 1070. I have a 1070 in my PC, and aside from like full 1440p, 165Hz, which is what this new monitor is, a 1070 is still pretty fucking good. I don't really like. I was thinking maybe I should get a new graphics card, but I don't know, man. 1070 is still taking names. It's nice. What's up, VF? You can buy Xbox Live Gold and upgrade it to Game Pass Ultimate for 1 quid. Oh yeah, that's what I did. Yeah. just giving you a password, I'll make good use of it. Are you looking to buy GameSpot shares? No. I gotta admit, I don't really have any idea what is going on with the whole GameSpot thing. GameStop, sorry. It is GameStop, right? Not GameSpot. But anyway. Yeah, I have no idea. It's been... that's one other thing of having had internet for like 2 days. It's amazing how much you feel out of the loop if you have a week being kind of unplugged from everything. I checked my email for the first time in a week, and there was all this shit I was like, man, go away. Like, leave me alone. Like these emails, for example. Like Prime Video is telling me what's just come to Prime. I don't care. I don't watch that much stuff on Prime. I have Prime for free delivery. I have Prime so I can order a keyboard and get it here tomorrow and not have to pay. It's nice. So. It really is, yeah. I mean, both systems are. I know the Series X is more powerful than a PS5, right? I didn't just make that up. I'm pretty sure the Series X is the more powerful. But again, the PS5, they are much more... Well, they're much harder to kind of beat now. And also, I don't know. Personally, I think it's kind of... If you want to do like a true console killer... and I feel like this makes it too easy for the PC. Hashtag not a PC fanboy. But I think if you're a real... like console person, you're probably gonna have both. So when people do like a console killer build, I would say it's fair to put the price of both of the systems together, and then that's your budget for your PC. But I feel like that makes it way too easy, especially like in the recent generations, to just make a PC that like blows the consoles out of the water. Like for example, when the like a PS3 and Xbox 360 towards the end of their life cycle, I mean, it wasn't hard to make a PC that was better than them, so. I'm just considering to get an Xbox Series X to get all the NG games at good frame rates. I mean, the Xbox One, you know? Oh, PS5 is more powerful. Oh, okay. Oh, I thought it was the Xbox. Yeah, I don't know. What do I do with my PS5? Okay, so here's a funny story. So my first night here... should I just change the... Okay, this is actually a good idea. Oh no, why? Where's my camera gone? Oh no. What? You see, this is what I mean, look. Why? Nothing has changed. Okay, screw it. Like, I don't know why my camera's not working on that one. I was gonna swap to like full screen. First night here, right? I didn't cook because obviously I had nothing set up, so I ordered takeaway for the first time in a long time. I had two pizzas. Two sides, and I ate them all to myself. I demolished that shit. I actually ate my pizza off of my PS5 box because I didn't have like I didn't have like a table or anything. And I was tempted to just like tweet a picture of that because I thought it would be funny, like using my PS5 as literally like a table to eat pizza off. Gift your PS5 to one of your viewers. Man, I mean, that would be a good way to, like, get people watching, I suppose. Like, it's like, yo, I have a PS5 to give away. Now, I'm gonna keep it, though. Who's gonna have some at second hand now, man? People might be like, no, JTB, like, might have COVID. I ain't getting no second hand PS5. Might die. honestly, 900 quid, 1,000, can't get you a good PC that can outperform the new consoles. I mean, maybe not outperform, but I guess it depends on... Because here's the other thing with PC budgets. That video I mentioned, by the way, for Linus Tech Tips, like, that doesn't include a monitor. Which I always think is kind of a cheat. Because if you have a console, especially newer consoles, like, you have to do that now. And if, like, GPUs weren't fucked like they are, but... all that really is just... It's a content thing. At the end of the day, get both. So... Oh, the Xbox Series X has better stats. Okay. I play all my... awesome Sphere. I did try RE4 on PS5. So... I mean, let's have a look. Let's check eBay, shall we? Let's see what a PS5's going for, and then I really need to check on my food. Yeah, let's see what a PlayStation 5 is going for right now. Because what I would probably do, I don't think I'd put it up for auction. Because fuck that. I'd probably put it up for like 700. Like, I'd undercut all the auction shit by like a good couple of hundred quid. And I'd just put it up for like 700 quid. Like, 750, buy it now, because it'd probably go like that. I mean, there's one here for a grand, 700, 750, 600, 800.
550, but that's a bid and that's only just gone live. 600. Man, look at all these. You know what, man? And this is tinfoil hat theory, but who doesn't love a good conspiracy theory? Are all these, like, scalping things, like, does anyone think they're all legit? I don't. I really don't. I don't think they're all legit, man. I think this is a good old bit of, well, we contracted out to a viral marketing firm, and they advised us we should do this. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, what's up, Doctor? Pizza Station 5. I should have took a picture of it, because it was kind of funny. I was literally just sat on my floor with, like, two pizza, like, two takeaway pizza boxes on the PS5, just eating pizza off it, because I didn't have anything else. So, just put it in the title and give it to yourself. Everybody does that. Nobody can prove it. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if people did that, honestly. It's really great, thanks, Al. It's really good. The office is about the only room that's, like, finished right now. Aside from, like, the... Literally, you guys can't see it. Aside from the giant pile of fucking plastic I have to get rid of. From, like, all the stuff that's arrived here over the past few days. So, I need to get rid of all that stuff. My recycle bin is full, so I need to wait for that to be empty before I can get rid of more stuff. But yeah, it wouldn't surprise me if they were all fake. Because no one's scalping the Xbox, are they? You haven't heard about the Xbox Series consoles getting scalped. And yet the PS5 stuff is everywhere. It's always everywhere. It's like, you know, PS5 stock, PS5 stock, PS5 stock. It's being scalped, man. And maybe I'm an idiot, but how are people doing it? Like, how are people, like, actually buying, like, you know, 2,000 PS5s on, like, one account? Like, surely not. Like, surely not. You can't buy more than 6 tins of fucking chickpeas at once, man, right now. How are people getting, like, 2,000 Xboxes, bro? Xbox Series X is scalped quite a bit. Oh, okay. I guess the Xbox just isn't... I suppose it really kind of shines a light on just how dominant the PS4 was. No one really gives a fuck about the Xbox. At least not seemingly in the UK. Like, no one really cares. It's all about the PS5. Like, everybody wants a PS5. But there's nothing on it worth playing. Literally, mine is sat next to a box of washing powder right now. It's just nothing to play on it. Like, and what a bill that Astro's Playroom was as well. I did actually play a little bit more of that before I moved. That game is a total bill. It's really not that good. Like, 650. Yeah, how much is it? So let's check Amazon. Can you just buy one right now? Xbox Series X. Nah, currently unavailable. Xbox Series S, currently unavailable. Can't buy shit. It's a weird time. Here's another thing too, thinking about it. We'll have this slight tangent, and then I'll wrap up. So in every other console launch, even the Switch, you've been able to go outside and just, you know, camp outside a shop. Can't do that right now, because the world is very different. Anybody in the chat, actually, in either chats, has anyone gone to, like, a midnight console launch and camped out? I'm curious. I've never done that. I've never been that dedicated, I gotta admit, to have a console. Like, I've never gone and camped outside a shop to get a system. But I mean, if you were around in, like, the PS2, especially in that era, I remember listening to, like, the old hotspots, like, when the old hotspot had a phone line where you could leave messages to, if any older people in the chat remember this. There were people that phoned into that phone line, like, while they were queuing for, like, a PS2, and they left voicemails. They're like, you know, hey, this is so-and-so, I'm queuing for a PS2 right now, and it's raining, and, you know. So, basically, everything on Xbox is on PC. Yeah, that's true, VF, yeah. It's a fair point. It's the main reason why I just don't think I'm gonna get a Series X, like, or a Series Xbox, because I think I just don't need one. I really don't. I can just get it on PC. The only thing I use my Xbox One for is NG,
and that handles it fine, so I don't know, man. It just kind of become a FIFA and COD machine. Yeah, I suppose. I mean, so many consoles, I think that's another thing that's an interesting point. So many consoles probably are FIFA and Call of Duty machines. Like, I know quite a few people, not like really well personally, but I know of people still, their consoles are literally just that. Like, they just play Call of Duty or they just play FIFA. That's it. They don't play anything else. So. I hope so too, hello. I really do. I would have for the Dreamcast. No, yeah, I didn't have the Dreamcast, so. It's like I'm waiting for my PS2, it's raining and I'm hungry. One voice message some guy was waiting, and when they actually opened, some dude literally hired like homeless people to wait in line for them, and he got like every PS2 at the shop. It's funny. Google this year collection if you want a really great, if you want like a really great like 12 hours of like hotspot highlights. Google this year collection hotspot podcast. Someone has done like a huge like highlight show for it. I loved the hotspot. That was back when saying like you listen to a podcast made people do this. What's a podcast, bro? Whereas now, like, everyone are there. Like, my dustbin probably has a podcast now. I never owned a Dreamcast. I still, like, want to get one at some point. Just to try it. I just want to try it. It's one of the only consoles I've never actually played. I've never played a Dreamcast. Yeah, come to think of it. I have never actually used a Dreamcast, ever. And I think it is about the only console I haven't used. Sports games do sell, yeah. Sports games sell like crazy. Call of Duty is basically just a sports game, except you shoot people instead. It's mad. So. Wrestling games were like that for a while, until they, like, you know, started just really not giving a shit. So, wrestling games came out every year, and, like, they used to sell very well. Remember when the wrestling games were good? That's crazy, isn't it? Like, I think they kind of peaked around, I'd say Here Comes the Pain was probably like the last time they ever made big changes to the wrestling game formula. SmackDown versus Raw 2006 was when they started kind of numbering them like that. That was good, but it kind of just built on what Here Comes the Pain did. But Here Comes the Pain was really good. No, you can't, Demon. Absolutely. Same with Call of Duty. I think if anyone's still waiting for, like, the Call of Duty thing to stop, like, it's never going to. Like, those games have just become, I don't know, like, you know, people that maybe had a season, like, I suppose a season ticket for, like, a football state maybe is a good comparison. That's, like, their equivalent. Like, some people, they just have their console and Call of Duty every year, and that's what they have, that's what they do. So, but yeah, it is weird. This could very well be like the first generation in a long time where I don't have both systems, because there's just nothing on that series that I want to play. The only thing that would get it is an NGB HD. Like, if they did a full on like NGB HD remake with the Hurricane packs, I hate to say it, but yeah, take my money. There's no way I wouldn't buy that. So. Yeah, I really wanted to play Soul Calibur. I was big into fighting games then, so I did really want to play Soul Calibur. I also wanted to play Resident Evil as well. If I remember rightly, the Dreamcast version of RE2 is like quite a bit different, isn't it? Like that's got modes on it that are only on the Dreamcast. I suppose you can get them like via emulation, but Def Jam Vendetta is awesome. Man, what a blast from the past. That was such a good game. That game, offline multiplayer. I miss offline multiplayer. I really do. So, it's got nightmare mode. What is nightmare mode? What is that? AGB HD remaster can swap between new and old graphics, HP 1 and 2 plus intercept, add a dual sword. Man, it'd be so good. It'd be so good. Man. I just... I don't want to say I've lost all hope, because, you know, you never know. But I mean, NGB is 15 years old at this point, so it's starting to look like we're probably never going to get that. You never know. So they basically just give you enough ammo to get through the game, tough as nails, zombies take a full clip to go down. Damn. Okay. That could be... Yeah, I'd want to play that. You know what? Let's have a look at Dreamcasts on eBay. And then... we'll wrap up here. Whoa! Okay, that's... more expensive than I would have thought. Man, these are around 100. If you want one kind of in, you know, good condition. If you want one that looks like it's been looked after. Yeah, you're looking at about 100 quid if you want one in good nick. Whoa, look at this. Holy crap. That is a haul. Also, I never actually had a Dreamcast, but there's something about the Dreamcast games, you know, the cases they come in, the way that they're just chonky, like they're just fat boys. Those Dreamcast jewel cases are just, you know, they've got fucking meat on them. You know what I mean? Like, you could use them for self-defense. They're just chunky. I like them. I miss the jewel case games. I miss when you, like, games came in fat jewel cases. I didn't actually know that PS1 games, I think, in the US, just used to come, like, in a jewel case. For anyone under the age of, like, 20, a jewel case is what a CD case is called. CDs used to be these things that, like, had music on them, and used to buy them, and used to put them in CD players. But in the US, they just used to come in like a regular CD case, whereas in the EU, you used to get a fat jewel case, you used to get a chonky case. Oh, it was so good. So, yeah, I mean, to be fair, I think we're getting to a point where Dreamcasts are well over 20 years old, so that's weird thinking about that. You know, I was going through, before I moved here, last tangent, and then we'll wrap up. Before I moved here, I went through, like, a lot of my stuff, like, gaming stuff, because I have a lot of gaming hardware, and I was thinking, man, because I have a Mega Drive that, last I checked, still works, and I thought, this thing's 30 years old next year, or this year, I can't remember. When did the Mega Drive come out? 91? I think, or 1990, I can't remember. And I was thinking, like, how long is it going to be until... Man, I just had a really depressing thought. Like, in my lifetime, and it's not going to be that long, we're, like, over the next 20 or so years, there's probably not going to be, like, a single functioning, like, pre-PS2 console in existence. That sucks. Like, that's made me sad to realize that. That's not good. I'll give you mine if you get an American Dreamcast. I'll never play RE2 again. And this is why, funnily enough, this is why I want to actually get emulation sorted. Because that's a way to play all these things, to play all these games still. Yeah, but yeah, I mean, think about it. The Mega Drive is almost 30 years old, and, I mean, they're not easy to come by now. And we're getting to a point where, like, you know, even the PS2 is 20 years old. So, yeah, it's original PS2 hardware. And with the transition from, you know, TVs, like, we went through a real TV, you know, paradigm shift. Like, even getting those old systems working on a new TV isn't easy, for the most part. So, emulation is the best. I don't care if it's piracy. I mean, yeah, technically speaking, Hello, I don't think it actually qualifies. If something is discontinued, I'm no lawyer. Disclaimer, I'm not a lawyer, but I don't think it counts if it's actually, like, no longer in production. There's got to be some lawyer channel on YouTube that does videos like that, right? We'll all send him that question. Like, I mean, think about it. No one is producing PS1 games anymore. Like, physically. On a disc. No one is manufacturing PlayStation 1 games. So, and would it even fall under piracy? Because, strictly speaking, the licensing agreement on games is, you know, you buy a license to play that game, and then if it's only you playing it via emulation, you're not duplicating the license. You're still only playing one game. I don't know. Again, I'm not a lawyer, but yeah, I know about that. Like, yeah, I'm just thinking, you know, eventually, you know, when I, like, for example, when I'm in my 60s, the odds of, like, functioning PS1s being out there are pretty slim. Yeah, it's mad, isn't it? Technically, emulation is legal, but game companies love to pretend it isn't. Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's another thing too. If it was easy, like, imagine this fantasy land for a while. Imagine if you could just put, like, an Xbox game in your PC, like, on a disc, rip it like you rip a CD, and just play it, like, flawlessly with no problems. How amazing would that be if you could just do that? If you could just rip a game to your PC and just play it with, like, no problem at all. Be so good. That would be a wish of mine. If anyone's seen Wonder Woman 1984, that would be mine. Like, just create this, like, emulation disc drive where you can just rip anything from it. And it has, like, a port on it where you can plug in, like, cartridges and shit. That'd be awesome. Anyway, guys, I'm going to wrap it there. This seems to be working fine, which is good. I wanted to make sure to get back to streaming because I thought if anything's going to go wrong with the internet, it's going to happen while I'm streaming. So we seem to be working really, really well here. So I might be back later tonight. Honestly, might just do a just chatting stream and just kind of chill. Because they're always fun. Funnily enough, Streamlabs have been, like, really promoting just chatting lately via their, like, updates and emails. Like, your stream needs just chatting. And I think, motherfucker, like, that's all my streams are. I barely play games anymore. We just talk. So, anyway, guys, I will catch you later. Maybe tomorrow, maybe later tonight. But keep an eye on Discord, and I will catch you then. Thanks for watching, everybody. Peace. See you later.